Hi, this is Rob with Botana Media. We're going to scan a photo using the Epson Perfection V330 photo scanner. We're going to scan a photo using the full auto mode on the Epson Perfection V330 photo scanner. If you want to see an unboxing and overview of the scanner, click here or the link below to see my unboxing video. Okay, I have my Epson Perfection correctly installed and the Epson Scan Software is correctly installed. Let's begin. Before you open the Epson Scan Software, you have to turn on the scanner. The on-off button is on the lower right. This window on the right will pop up when you open the Epson Scan Software. In the upper right-hand corner of the window, make sure you are in the full auto mode. Then you want to see the customized settings and change them if necessary. Click the Customize button, then this window pops up. On the top of this window, you have to specify the document type, photograph/document or film. I'll choose photograph/document. Now we need to choose a resolution. What resolution do we need? That depends. If you're going to email or post this photo online, then choose 100 dpi, because most computer monitors are only 72 to 96 dpi. If you are scanning for Apple's Retina display devices, then you should use 264 dpi. But I have used as low as 72 dpi and the photos still look good on Apple's Retina display devices. If you're scanning the photo for archiving or printing reasons, then choose 300 dpi. However, if you like to make enlargement prints from this scan, then you need to choose 600 dpi. This will give you more pixels to make enlargement. Dust removal. If you choose this option, the Epson Perfection V330 will perform an extra scan to detect and remove photo imperfections such as dust, residue, and small scratches. I'm going to leave this unchecked. Color restoration. Choosing this option will restore old, faded, color-shifted photos to near original colors. Well, this is what Epson says. I have not tested this feature yet, but many say that it is easier to adjust colors in Photoshop. I'll do a future video on the color restoration feature. I'll leave this box unchecked. Auto photo orientation. I've tested this feature and it works good. Without this feature checked, you need to place the upper left-hand corner of the photo face down in the lower left-hand corner of the scanner. With this feature turned on or checked, you can place any corner of the photo face down in the lower left-hand corner of the scanner, and the Epson Perfection does a good job of making sure the photo is right side up after scanning. This is a good feature when you can't remember which corner of the photo you need to place down. File save settings. Click this button to choose where to save the scanned photo, naming of the scanned photo, and the image format of the scanned photo. I'm going to click here. This window pops up. Location. Choose the location where you want the scanned photo to be saved. Documents folder, pictures folder, or a folder of your choosing. I'm going to choose the pictures folder. Your options may be different if you're using a Windows PC. File name. The folder name is going to be a prefix and a 3-digit number. You can choose anything that you want as a prefix and then choose a 3-digit start number. Image format. You have multiple choices, JPEG, TIFF, PDF, PIC, etc. Your choices may be different if you're using a Windows PC. I'm using a Mac, thus the PIC format is one of my choices. PIC is an image format developed for Macintosh graphics. Click OK, and click OK again. Let's place the photo in the scanner. Place the upper left-hand corner of the photo face down in the lower left-hand corner of the scanner. In the lower left-hand corner of the scanner is an arrow to remind you where to place your photo for scanning. Close the lid of the scanner. Go to the Epson Scan Software. Make sure you are in full auto mode in the upper right-hand corner. Then, click the big scan button. The Epson Perfection will automatically detect the type of document. In this case, the color photo. Okay, it's scanned and the photo is saved in the pictures folder. The pictures folder opens up and here's the photo, IMG002 JPEG. I'll double click on it to open up the photo. That's the photo, looks good. And that's it for this tutorial. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to this channel.